I'm going to show you how to use a multimeter in this video here. I'm going to tell you what to look for when you're buying one and how to use the different options available on here and the difference between those options and difference between an inexpensive and an expensive multimeter. So let's get started with this right now. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And you're going to need a multimeter while you're working on your track and other components on your railroad. And I'm going to show you how to use one here. Now, it doesn't have to be this one here. This is an old one that's discontinued, so don't try to look for this model here. But you could buy them anywhere, any place that has hardware. Even Walmart has them. And just look for the best price. Now, for model railroading, you're not going to need a lot of options on there. You're going to want DC voltage, maybe AC voltage to check your outlets, resistance, and amperage. Now, a bonus would be for capacitance and for checking diodes. Not all meters have them on there, but that's an extra feature that you could have. This is an auto range multimeter, which means that you just have to set it to your ohms on here for resistance, and it'll automatically select the range on there. Some multimeters are going to have a lot more data up here. They're going to have a lot more ranges to choose from. And don't worry about that. I'll show you how to use those also. Those are the ones that don't have the automatic range on it. So, you know, it's always good to find one if you can with the auto ranges on them. The price of multimeters are getting less expensive now, so you could probably pick up a good multimeter for about $30. Some meters have just three options for probes. Some of them have four. On this one, the amperage is auto range on there up to 10 amps, and it'll go down to the milliamps like other multimeters. But some other multimeters will have a fourth one on there, and then it will have amp and then milliamps. This is an easy one where you don't have to move the probes around a lot, just for checking all your functions from here, and the amperage is over here. On the ones with four, you might have to change it from the amperage to milliamps. Before I go any further with this, I'm going to talk a little bit about safety. Okay, every multimeter is going to come with a set of probes on it. You're going to have a black and a red one. Do not put your probes into a live circuit unless you know what you're doing, unless you're an electrician. Turn everything off, put your probes in there, then turn it on. That's the best way to do it. Be very careful because electricity can kill you. Always be careful, know what you're doing, and turn the circuit off before you start poking your probes in there. So be careful. That means you, all of you. This meter is a Fluke 111 true RMS multimeter. And the reason they call it a multimeter is because it has several functions on there that you could test with it. Now, we're going to talk about the AC voltage, the DC voltage, check continuity with a beep, the resistance, it's going to show you a reading in ohms. This is for checking diodes, this is for checking capacitors. We won't go into that on this discussion here. That's a little bit more advanced. I'm just going to give you the basic ones. And this is for reading AC amperage, and this is for reading DC amperage. We'll talk about the DC amperage on here. We're going to do voltage, continuity, resistance, and DC amperage, and I'll show you how to do all of them there. You have three places where you could put your leads. The common lead, you're going to have your black one there all the time. Okay, whenever you're going to check amperage, you're going to put your red lead in this one here. Some multimeters have amps and milliamps. So, but this is an auto range, so you just have one here. Now for the voltage, the resistance, the continuity, the diode, and the capacitor, you're going to put your red probe in this one right here. As far as the functions go on here, you have AC voltage, you have DC voltage. This is a continuity checker. This will show you resistance. And this will be for diodes and capacitors, which we'll show in another one. And this one, AC amperage and DC amperage. Some multimeters will have ranges in the voltage and the resistors and the amperage. And I'll put a picture up here showing you what that is over on this side over here. But anyway, this is just a simple dial right here without all the different ranges on there, because it's the ranges are set internally. We're going to start this off by checking DC voltage on this. So I'm going to put the probe, black probe, in the common, and I'm going to put the red probe in the volt, ohm, diode, and capacitor plug right there. All right. Okay, we have DC volts right there. Now, whenever you're checking, okay, now it shows up 9 volts minus 9 volts. This is also a good way of determining which lead is the positive and which lead is the negative. Your black lead is the negative lead, but I had it on the positive. So if I turn it around this way, it shows 9.0 volt. That's a good battery right there. Okay, now before I started this, I pulled out the first battery I pulled out. It wasn't a good battery. Okay, now I'll put the leads on here. Oops. It's going flying. You have 6.3 volts. Okay, that's telling me that that battery isn't putting out 9 volts, and it's going to tell you whatever you have it in, it's going to say replace this battery. Now we're going to do AC volts, and we're going to do it on just a regular power strip. And right now I have the power turned off, so I'm going to put the probes in here. Put it on my range for AC volts. And you see this right here. That's normal. You'll see that all the time. But I'll turn the power strip on, and 122 volts. Now we're going to do the continuity checker. That's this little like waveform right here. You can see you put the leads together and you get a little beep on there. All right, so we'll just test things here. That must not be metal right there. On the screwdriver. Okay, here's my soda can. Okay, on there, no continuity. We'll take one of these breadboards, no continuity like that, but if I stuck my probe inside there, you would get continuity. So we'll go over to ohms, and when I put my leads together, it'll show up somewhere near zero. So it says 0.2. Now The reason why it's showing 0.2 is because in these leads right here, you also have resistance. So it's not a true flow of electrons with no resistance through your wires. So there's a little bit of resistance in there. So we're just going to take the two leads on this resistor right here, and we got 54.9 k ohm. okay, now I have another resistor right here on there that I'm going to use on the next demonstration, and this one is 216.7. now that's approximate because this is a 220 ohm resistor right here. Now I want to show you a different kind of test lead on here, and these just plug right into your normal probes, and these are for, I use these on circuit boards and other things, but you can see the little hook in there. Now I'm going to hook this side of the resistor and this side of the resistor so I don't have to hold it, and we'll just bring it up to the ohms and 54.7 k ohms. All right, on that probe, and we'll bring this one on this probe, and you don't have to hold it, 216.7. So these are very useful tools to add on to your probe. Put my battery in a little holder, so I have a little connector here. My little power source right here with the 9-volt battery is hooked up to the LED. I'm going to break the circuit right here, and that's what we have to do. We have to put the ammeter in the circuit, otherwise it will not read. So we have it there, and we'll put the other lead right here. And excuse me for being a little bit sloppy here, and we'll turn this on, and it shows up 0.028. All right, now that's on the 220 ohm resistor. We're getting two lessons here: how to use the ammeter and a little lesson on Ohm's law. Okay, now I'm going to increase the resistance going to a 270 ohm resistor, and that's going to drop down to 0.024, so that's like 24 milliamps. That's all we have for this demonstration of the multimeter. I'll have another one later on, maybe in a couple of weeks, to go a little bit further into detail on this. If you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell, and that'll notify you whenever I have a new video coming out. And if you would like to support this channel, go on over to my Patreon page, patreon.com/TomKovichak, where you could pledge your support and help me out so I could get me some more sodas or something. But anyway, thank you. So that's it for today. Stay tuned for more demonstrations on the principles of electrical and electronics, and we'll see you down the road somewhere. Okay.